Maayong buntag. Can I get my just to at least know where who I'm talking to? Because I'm not really used to, just like what Sir Peter mentioned, most of my life was in the basketball court. So this is actually the second time I was here, and I'm excited because I look forward to seeing the corporate side of things, seeing the perspective of you guys. That's why I'm here right now. And I just want to change a perspective, I guess, that we are always branded. Kasi when I get invites, Coach, kailangan namin ng motivational speaker. And I guess I'm not really a motivational speaker. I just give you perspective. And it's up to you if you will apply it or not. Kasi pag sinabing motivation, it has to come from you. I mean, leading into your people. So hindi yan manggagaling sa akin. What I just do is just to give a few of my perspective, and hopefully it's gonna connect, it's gonna resonate. And at the end of the day, we are dealing with human beings. So let's not take away that concept. And I was speaking to Sir Irvin kanina, again, new to corporate, kahapon daw, I think you guys were talking about technical skills. Parang how to do stuff, how to sell the product. I heard Sir Johan mentioning din kanina about ICOS, that new brand. And he mentioned soft skills. And I wasn't aware of that. What's soft skills? So hard skills is the, tama ba? The gamit, the and then the soft skill is? Yeah. So can we call that soft skill human skills? Diba? Para it more on pertains to a person. Kasi soft skill, parang we're not really soft as we have to be hard. Kasi this field that we're in doesn't, if you want to survive in this field, you have to be hard. Right? Being soft lands you here. Diba? I was so animated by Sir Peter. I want it! Kasi namin dito! So it's gonna be hard. Just to start. So it's not gonna be easy. Para lang I get the context. So I was listening to kanina Sir Johan, right? So Sir Johan, let's call him Sir Johan, and then Sir Peter. So I just want to know. And then after Sir Peter, we're dealing with managers. Yeah. Okay. So the managers. Next is the supervisors. Yeah, supervisors. Okay. So after the supervisors. Okay, ito na yung, yeah, they're the ones in the ground. I think, yes, sobrang timing yung pasok ni Sir Johan because I get to, yung where he's coming from. So these are the men and women. Kumbaga, kasi sa amin, we have our team owner, the manager, the coach, the players, and also that's where actually, it's the other way around. Yeah. So again, just so you know where I'm coming from, at least I know where I stand. I was talking to Sir Peter and he was talking about this is the world that I imagined. I mean, it incorporated in my coaching style and hopefully it's going to win me championships. But yesterday wasn't fortunate.
It was a hard day.
Because UP was the better team yesterday, but kaya nga kanina ko pa kausap si Ma'am Joanne, kalaban pala. But going back to what I want to talk about, do you want to work for a company that makes you feel safe? Alam niyo yung feeling na when you go to work, you feel excited? Kaysa yung you go to work na pagising nyo, pwede ba magmura? Di ba? Yung pagising mo, kikita ko na naman yung pangit na yun. You know the feeling that you're being dragged to come to work, but have you felt that you belong to a team that you feel excited coming to work? And when you're there, you feel safe? Yung lahat naka-tuck in? Kasi walang may kutsilyo sa likod at sasaksakin ka. Di ba? But most importantly, you go home feeling fulfilled. Ilan sa atin dito yung nadadala yung trabaho sa bahay? Diba? Alam nyo ba yung kasama doon? Hindi lang yung physical of the things that you have to bring to work, but also the emotions that you bring. Right? And alam nyo yung feeling na stress ka din alam mo sa bahay? And who's gonna be the direct? Kumbaga sa Granada, sino yung unang makaka-receive nun? Diba? Asawa, anak. Diba? Halos lahat eh. Diba? So that's what we always bring to work. If we come here, nawala to. Ano ba yung feeling ng fulfilled? You are? You feel? Valued. What else? Pinaka-importante. You felt heard. Yun yung napaka-importanteng bagay. And I'm gonna go back dito sa kanina na tinanong ko. So we're talking with managers, right? And I asked Sir Peter kanina, sino dito yung, even the supervisor, sino dito yung nagsimula dito? Right? So, I think we're unanimous na in a way, nagsimula tayo dito. But, when was the last time you went to a store, just like what Sir Johan, sakto yung timing yung pasok ni Sir Johan, he was mentioning about, when was the last time you went here? Personally sell a product? Every day? Like you talk to the stores? Wow. There's a reason why you are successful. Right? But, just like what Sir Peter said, kulang pa, di ba? Kulang pa. Kasi nga, internally, di ba, again, I know the challenges that the Visayas region has because of strategic, geographical challenges, but you were still able to thrive. But, again, it's always going to have challenges. That's why it's very important that we're going to come in as a united front. Kailangan. Hindi pwedeng yung dalawa lang ang nag-i-strive and then the rest, hindi kasama. Hindi pwedeng i-invite lang ni Sir Peter yung dalawang successful tapos yung dalawang medyo not on the good side. Di ba ang hirap nung ganun? And it's always going to be important if you want to move forward, if you want to move fast, move alone. If you want to go far, go together. Kasi ang hirap eh. Ang hirap na ikaw lang eh. Yung alam mo yung feeling mo, dala mo yung daigdig. So, why not have that mindset that everybody matters? Kasi we're always dealing with, yun nga, yung sa technical skills eh, we always deal with numbers, systems, but we forget that we're dealing with human beings. Yung nagdadala niyang, sorry, whatever it is is tao eh. Sometimes we're forgetting about it. Kahit gano'n pa to kaganda, gano'n pa to ka-advance, tao pa rin magdadala. So, I mean, if you really want to make sure that everybody matters, everybody, it doesn't only mean the managers, the supervisors, I mean everybody. Kasi they bring your product. So we build great people to do extraordinary things. Ito yung question, are we really building? Kasi ang daling sabihin, drive sales! Hit the projection! But are we building those people to deliver? Parang sa basketball din yan eh. Tuturuan mo yan palagi, but sometimes you're forgetting that you're not dealing with numbers. When I was here the last time, I talk about, instead of head count, talking about heart count. Kasi sometimes tinitingnan lang natin sila, ah, number one, number two, oh, deliver kayo. Ah, 4-5, pwede kayo. 9-10, mag-isip na kayo. Anong feeling, di ba, na they don't even know your name? That's one of the feelings of being valued or being heard, which sometimes nakakalimutan na natin. We have to go back, even as a basketball world, sometimes we get so caught up with, kasi so, sakit sa ulo tong YouTube na to eh. Pag-click mo lang, kailangan ko ng opensa, kailangan ko ng depensa, bibigyan ka ng napakaraming information. And you're forgetting at the end of the day, players still gonna win games for us. Hindi kami. Kahit gaano kami kagaling, kahit gaano kami katalino, kahit gaano kami kasikat, if we don't treat those players as human beings, they're not gonna win games for us. So minsan na-overwhelmed tayo ng technical skills eh. And I guarantee you, after this three-day event that you have, you're gonna be loaded with so much information, right? But the challenge is, how can you deliver it to your people? That's why we have to make sure we talk about human skills. Ano ba yung mga human skills? Coach Topex. Sorry, yeah. Pa-practice lang. Well, human skills, pretty much talks about this. Ano ba yung mga human skills that we're forgetting? How to give and receive feedback. That's a human skill. Hindi, you're not born with it. It's a something that you need to work on. Ang hirap nito ah, if you're not good at it. Kasi why? Minsan parang feeling mo, defensive ka eh. Kasi hindi ka sanay mag-receive ng feedback. Lalong-lalo na, hindi ka rin sometimes marunong magbigay. It has to be a two-way street. Hindi pwedeng, since ako yung may mataas na position, ako lang may karapatan. Pero si sales, ah, wala. Bago ka lang dito eh. Ako, 20 years na ako dito. Diba? Sometimes we're forgetting that giving and receiving feedback is important. You know how it looks like? Those difficult conversations. Sometimes ang hirap sabihin kasi takot tayo sa ganun eh, yung conflict. Iniiwasan natin yun. So minsan, hindi, ikaw nang bahala dyan. Ah, resolvahin nyo na yan. So you just make it so easy just to get away from it. But the problem is, kailangan natin daanan yun eh. Kasi that's the only way we could connect to our people. The everyday people that depends on us as our leaders. Okay? So, handling conflict, napakahirap nito pag hindi natin pinapractice. Umiiwas nga tayo dito, di ba? Kaya nga iba dito, umuwi ng lasing, di ba? Parang naririnig. Kasi ayaw natin ng conflict eh. We're trying to walk away from it, but the problem is, whether we like it or not, we have to go through it. Yung everyday dealings with of sales, they need that. Tinuturo ba natin yan? Or we're just assuming alam na nila? That's why I was asking earlier, by show of hands, sino dito yung that went from really there to where you are now? And when was that? Kumbaga na everyday. I mean, things change. Like with basketball now, hindi na pwede yung wala na yun. Bawal na yung kakaldagin mo yung player or mumurahin mo. Yeah. Kailangan na ngayon dito is, yeah. You have to give them inspiration. Kahapon, I was so motivated. Ah, let's beat UP. We're undefeated. We're 11-0. Jump ball. Dioff, dunk. Cancino, 3. Motivation. Right? But you want to give them inspiration. I mean, there's no finish line, but we have to keep on striving. Sir Johan was mentioning about 2024. Why not think about 2028? See? Right now, we're not even looking at that because why? Hirap na tayo pa nga lang sa 23, right? paano ba tayo makakasurvive sa 2024? More sa 2028. Iniisip pa lang natin yun. Why? Because we don't really have the tools to make us thrive not only in this situation, but further down the road. Another thing, eto, isa pa to. Yung listening skills na to. You know what school? Ano tinuturo sa atin? Speaking class. Debate class. Di ba? But we don't have listening class. We have peace talks, but we don't have peace listens. Ito kasing sakit natin eh. I mean, etong ano natin, may sinasabi pa lang sa atin yung tao natin or yung kausap natin, ano na ginagawa natin? We are already formulating an answer. I mean, it goes to everybody. Diba? That's one of the skills that if we learn to master, that will always give us an advantage. I have to go back to, I think we were unanimous here when we said, we want to be. Yeah, want to be valued. How can you be valued if you don't, if you feel that you weren't feel heard? So ito yung isang bagay that's so important. You know what's so challenging now since nung time natin when we were doing sales, when we were having meetings, we don't have, you know how it feels when you're in a meeting, di ba? Alam niyo yung meeting ngayon, yung round table, pag wala pa si boss, yeah, everybody's on their phone. Itanong niyo yung mga anak niyo dito sa klase, meron pa bang naglilista ng noisy?
Wala na,
di ba? Di ba? Katahimikan. Kasi lahat, they're on their phone. Not only them, it's also us. Di ba? We're so good at multitasking now. Di ba? Yung tao dito sa paligid natin, physically we're here, pero, di ba? We're somewhere else. So how do you feel? How can you be heard if you're having a conversation with one of your sales team and you're on your phone? Do you think you feel valued? Ito pang sakit natin. Ito yung nakakatawa eh. Di ba nagre-ring yung phone? Tumitingin tayo. Tapos, anong gagawin natin? Babalikta rin. As if it wasn't man. Di ba, ginagawa natin, binabaliktad lang natin, feeling natin na, hindi, ikaw, mas importante ka. Kaya binaliktad ko na yung phone ko eh. Pero nakatingin pa rin ako sa phone ko. How would you feel? Do you think you'll feel valued? You'll feel heard? If you're having a conversation with your people? How would you feel if you're talking to your boss and you have issues? And your boss is on the phone while he's talking to you? Will you come out of that room feeling valued? Hello? Hindi. And we bring these people out into the battle knowing na bahala ka sa buhay mo, hindi nga ako pinakinggan eh. So what do you expect your people to do? Does it breed loyalty? Does it build trust? Etong maganda, you know with trust? Trust is not an instruction. Ganda nung sa mga basketball, yung mga commercial eh. Na when you talk about trust, yung, oh, ikaw, magtiwala kayo sa isa't isa, ha? It's not an instruction, it's a feeling. Diba? Bago kayo magtiwala sa girlfriend nyo or sa asawa nyo ngayon, hindi naman yan nangyari, diba? Pagkagising nyo, gusto na kitang pakasalan. Diba? It's a feeling. You have to go through a lot of things together. Shared values, shared challenges, shared success. That's how you build trust. That's where... Yeah, we build it. That's where the military has and corporate doesn't have. Because they will really die for each other. Imagine if you have that kind of team that your people will die for you. Kahit bagyo na yan, kahit sang lupalot pa yan ng tindahan, pupuntahan ko yun. Kasi, mahal ako ni boss eh. Di ba? Ang sarap ng feeling, di ba, na merong ganong empleyado na kahit anong, hindi yung sumisip-sip ha. Di ba? Hindi yun ano, because they really feel that you value them. Sino dito, I mean, for a supervisor, how many people do you handle? 10? 8? 10? 10? Do you get to choose your people? No? Yes? No? Sometimes, not all the time, but majority is? No. Do you get to choose your children?
Unfortunately,
not. Right. Right? But what do we give our children? The best. Di ba? Pag-uwi ng bahay niyan at nag-i-struggle sa klase, hindi mo sasabihin niyan, anak, bobo ka eh. I'm gonna put you up for adoption. I'm gonna get a smarter kid. Di ba? Do we do that? If only. Di ba? But anong ginagawa natin sa anak natin? We support them. We give them care. Diba? Pinapakinggan natin sila. We give them empathetic listening. Anak, ano bang nangyari? Diba? Minsan, sasabihin pa natin, si Raulo naman yung professor mo eh. Just to make them feel good. Diba? If your children comes out, Dad, talo kami sa basketball eh. Galing nung kalaban. O sige anak, anong gagawin mo sa anak mo? Hahanapan mo ng skills coach or swimming coach or whatever coach that you have kasi you want him to succeed, right? What if ganun ba yung feeling natin sa mga tao natin? Kapag nag-i-struggle yung tao natin, do we give them not only technical skills, which you all know, but do we give them this? Imagine niyo na lang if the 8 of your people na hindi mo naman talaga nabigyan ng chance na piliin sila, but sometimes napipili natin, eh paano yung hindi? So does it mean yung tatlo na yon or apat yun yung thriving? Kasi yun yung pinili natin. So what happens to the 4? They're gonna rot and die. What's gonna happen to sales? Kaya nga, this is very important. Most importantly, ito yung wala, how to ask for help. They don't have the courage to ask. That's the problem. Because you always think, kaya mo na yan. Tagal mo na dyan eh. Di ba? Meron na ba nagsabi sa inyo dito na, sir, hindi ko kaya. Ano ba pwede mo maitulong? Bakit wala silang courage? Because if they show that, and if things get messy, sila yung una. Ma-chuchugi. That's why they don't have the courage. How can they ask for help to somebody that they don't even know? They just know you as their bosses or their direct supervisor, but do they also know you as human beings? Ang problema sa atin, we always put on a mask. A supervisor ako eh. Ma manager. But we also ask, di ba? We also have our challenges. But kasi we always put on a mask that we are always in command. That's why it's really hard to ask for help. Even tayo sometimes, we feel like we want to ask for help. Pero baka pag nagtanong ako ng ano, baka sabihin nila mahina akong leader. And in a safe environment, everybody feels safe. You could raise your hand and tell them, I'm sorry, I don't know the answer. I'm sorry, I'm struggling. That's really important in a group that you treat your own. So share ko lang yesterday, so since we lost. It's hard, yeah. Sakit. We were 11-0 and everybody was there expecting us to win a championship. And guess what? We got beaten. We only didn't get beaten, we got beaten bad. If our environment wasn't safe there, I couldn't easily say, Guys, sorry, hindi ko kayo na-prepare. Kung hindi ako safe dun sa mga kasama ko, what will I do? Ah, kasalanan mo. Puro ka tira. Hindi ka namamasa. Hindi ka dumidepensa. But because I want to project that I'm always strong. Not ako tama palagi. But if you could even read the write-ups right now, I have to take ownership. You have to have that courage to be the one jumping off that building. You know the challenge here? You have to live it day by day. Because the only way you'll build, dito naman ako, that's the only way you will build integrity. Hindi pwedeng kung okay lang, ah, appear, chest bump, yes! Pero pag natatalo na, di ba? Kakanya-kanya na tayo. Ah, pag sales, okay. Celebrate! The only way you're gonna be a leader is you have followers. When you have followers, that means they do whatever it is that you want them to do. Hindi dahil, ah, kasi boss ka eh. Ito na yung kutsilyo. Di ba? This is very important. These are human skills that hindi na natin tinuturo. We're just assuming. We will always be in the people's business. Kailangan hindi mawala yun. Nakakalimutan natin eh. Again, because of what? Numbers. The problem with the hierarchy, authority is always on top. Information is sa baba. Again, that's why I went back to my question, how many of you has gotten to sales? That's where all the information is. Kasi sila yung, yun nga, sobrang, it resonated with Sir Johan said. Pagka kinuusap mo yung babae, pagka bubbly, ah, okay, alam na kita kung paano kita atakihin. Ah, pag may si mister, or si other half, nag-smoke, okay. Di ba? When was the last time we went there? And check. And be with our sales people. I really like it when you said, palagi. There's a reason why you are thriving as a group. That's a reason why Sir Peter is so proud of you. But there's also a reason why he wants more. That's the reason why you're here. Because he believes in you. You know, the thing about leadership, ito kasi yung palagi nating nakikita eh. Di ba pag leader, gusto natin palagi? Di ba? Hoo, dito tayo! Di ba? Why not? Dito tayo. Okay, kumakaliwa, kumakanan medyo, kaliwa natin konti. But, that's 2024. That's 2028. So, you should bring everybody there. Hindi pwedeng dalawa lang. Ah, pag ikaw, ah, dyan ka na. Iiwan ka dyan. Di ba? How would you feel? Will you feel fulfilled if your leader is there? Would you feel heard or valued if something's going wrong? How would you feel? Sino to sa buhay natin? Bakit mahal na mahal natin yung mga magulang natin? Kasi hindi nila tayo pinapabayaan, di ba? Yun yung nakakalimutan natin eh. And sometimes, again, because we're so driven by numbers, by metrics, that we're forgetting that, again, tao pa rin tayo eh. Di ba? Sometimes, we're up. Sometimes we're down. And one thing that was mentioned to me that I've changed my narrative of a competitor. Now I call them my worthy rival. Kasi pag competitor, tingin natin palagi kalaban eh. Di ba? Which is true. That's what, dun tayo pinalaki. Di ba? Competitor. Yari ka sa akin. Di ba? But what if you consider them as your worthy rival? And what does a worthy rival look like? You call him a worthy rival because his strength reveals your weakness. Saan siya nagtatrive? The reason why he's thriving in that part is because you're not thriving in that part. But since you beat him, you call him as your competitor, you're not seeing what he's doing good that you could also apply kasi gusto mo siya palagi talunin. You want to beat him to the bush. I have a lot of worthy rivals. Tab is one of my worthy rivals. Now, Coach Goldwin is one of my worthy rivals. I have to accept the fact that sometimes I win, sometimes I lose. Sometimes I'm up, sometimes I'm down. But I'm just gonna keep on moving forward. Kasi sometimes we're putting so much energy, ano bang ginagawa nila sa kabila? That we're not seeing also where we're good at. Sometimes nakakalimutan na natin where we, bakit ba tayo for the past, what, 2 years, 3 years, we've been up there. Ano ba yung tama natin ginagawa? As the Visayas region. Sometimes nakakalimutan natin eh. Kasi we're so focused on kabila. Ano yung ginagawa ng kabila? Why not invest a lot of our energy running our own race? Yeah, we look at the metrics. I'm sure you always get that number. But are you focusing on the right aspect of the game? You're always looking at the finite numbers. Why not look at the infinite? That's how you invest in your people. Diba? Parang sinabi natin, you treat them as your own. Pagka nag-struggle yung isang tao natin, let's treat them as our own. Ano magagawin natin? Stand beside him. O, kamusta ka na? How is it going now? Ano bang problema natin dyan? Ano bang challenges? How would you think those people will feel if their supervisors always listens to them? Ito yung feeling natin that dinig ako ni boss. Sarap naman ang feeling. Hindi na ako lilipat sa kabila. Ganon din naman pala. Eh. Dito, at least, mahal ako ng boss ko. I mean, di ba? Meron tayong ganon. Na, di ba, kaya tayo nandito kasi, here, we feel valued. Why not thrive because we treat our people as human beings? Why not thrive in that aspect? I guarantee you, the other team is also focusing so much on the numbers, so much on the tactical, which, again, you cannot survive with that also. I'm not saying you're gonna do away with that and just, human skills na lang, love, love, hug, hug, kiss, kiss. No, it's not. But try to balance it. Try to balance it. I'm sure there's a way that we could try it. Just treat everybody as human beings. And I just want to ask this question, which I hope we could resonate. Why do you do what you do and where is it taking you? Like, have you asked yourself that question? Because sometimes, again, sorry, dito ba si Ma'am Joanne? Joanna, sorry, I was having a conversation with her. She's on HR, di ba? And I asked her, what did she took up? She took up international studies, and I asked her, how's the challenges? Because in sales, it's hard. One of the things that we should also take out of our vocabulary is easy. It's hard. Let's try to accept hard, get better at hard. Because if you want to be here, okay lang. Easy, okay lang. Hit na natin, mga... Kontrolin lang natin, mga sampo lang. Huwag muna tayong bumente. Kasi pag naka-20 tayo, expect next month ni boss, 20 na palagi. Dito lang tayo sa 8, 10. Para may time pa tayo makapag-relax. Kasi pagka hinit natin ng 20, expected na ni Sir Peter palaging 20 eh. Di ba? But alam niyo ba kung bakit yung ginagawa yun? Kasi you might be on the wrong business. Sabi ko nga kanina, I'm not here to motivate you. I'm here to give you perspective. I'm not here to win friends. I'm here to give you difficult conversations. I'm not saying I'm successful. And I'm mag-iayabang ako ano yung mga pinagagawa ko, ano yung mga chip. Talo nga eh. But this gets me excited. Because I know what I love to do. I want to give, share, inspire. I get excited. Actually, later, I have a championship game. Meron pa kaming game. But I'm here because I love doing this. I love sharing whatever it is that I could share because I know what I wanted to do. And I know where it's taking me. Because I don't want to wake up one day knowing that I failed. I might be successful at doing things, pero hindi pala yun yung gusto kong gawin all along. Baka hindi kayo dito sa business na to. Kasi, Sir Peter wants to take you to a place that he cannot do alone. And he needs you. And he needs everybody. He doesn't only need 5, 6. He needs all of you. Just like a father, he gives you skills. That's why he brought you here. I know the challenges, it's like what I mentioned, of being geographically challenging for you guys. Do you want to work for a leader that has a vision? Diba? Sino, diba? Parang, gusto nyo ba, Al? Kayong sampo, tapong ko na kayo dyan. Bahala na kayo. Balikan nyo ako, ha? Bigyan nyo ako ng huli. Diba? But how would you feel if you know your leader is setting a vision that's impossible sometimes? Sabi mo, si Raulo yata itong boss ko eh. That's what a vision is. And do you want to work for a leader that has that vision? Can I share you my vision with my team right now? Obviously, you want to win a championship. But my vision for them is 15 years from now, they'll be better person, better than when I found them. That's my vision for them. Winning is just going to be the byproduct of what I'm doing right now. I'm not even sure if I'll be coaching that team 15 years from now. But I guarantee myself, alam niyo yung feeling, I have coaches na pag nakita ko sa malayo, si coach, iiwasan ko. But I also have coaches na kahit nakatalikod dyan, hahabulin ko yan at kakamustahin ko. Now I'm gonna ask you, sino ba kayo doon? Diba? Kayo ba yung gusto niyo yung supervisor na pag nakita kayo or pag nakita kayo, ay, kupal yan eh. Hello? Diba? I mean, or you wanna be that person na mahal ako niyan. Kahit anong mangyari, sasaluhin ko yung granada para dyan. That's a question that I'm gonna leave you with. Do you wanna work for people that will die for you? Na kahit bagyo, lalabas yan. Kasi, they're not just doing it for them. They wanna do it for you. And as you're sitting there now, I wanna challenge you. Do you wanna be that person? Because it's gonna take a lot from you. It's gonna be hard. But what I guarantee you is you will also be fulfilled with the work that you do. That's gonna keep you going through times, especially in these times that you have to transition, that you have to go through from where you're so accustomed to 20 years of selling this product to now where the management wants you to go to that danger zone. Are you ready? Are you prepared? I cannot answer that for you, but that's a choice that you have to take. The fact that you're here right now, that means you're gonna go there no matter what. Question na lang is, who will go with you? Because that's gonna define who you are as a leader. Maraming salamat po.